for the day. Today we are going to deal with the second year subject, that is Engineering Geology Practical Number 1, that is Megascopic Identification of Mineral Specimen. So we have to identify these mineral specimen in the field by studying its physical properties. So physical properties, we can already get it in your theory part, that is physical properties like color, streak, luster, diaphanity, and its tenacity. So all these things we are going to study today. So first, physical property is color. So color is light reflecting property. Color is, we can identify, this is rosy pink color, this mineral is white color, this mineral is green color with white bands. So it is zebra agate and it shows the zebra bands. So grayish white, whitish green, or transparent. So there are so many minerals that you cannot understand by its one color, because most of the minerals are transparent, like this transparent quartz. But the chemical impurities give them some of the color. For example, this is rosy quartz. So when the impurities are seen in the mineral, then we can identify this with the new color. So color is least identified property, least important property for the identification of minerals. But for example, malachite or ruby is always found in the particular color. So that is one property you need to understand. Second property is streak. Streak is color of mineral powder. So why it is different than color? Because streak is, if we make the powder of this mineral, its color will be different than the original in some cases. For example, if we take this graphite, its color is gray, and this is the streak plate. We are going to study the streak on this. That is, we are going to use this hard porcelain unglazed plate to check the streak. So grayish color, and if we check the streak, that is color of the powder is also gray. So color is same as well as streak is same. If we have the talc, color is white, streak is also white. So generally mineral will show the same color as its powder, but few examples, few exceptional cases, like this is hematite. Hematite mineral has the grayish black color, but its streak will be, its streak is cherry red color. So this is how it differs and makes the special property of hematite. So hematite has the grayish black color, but its streak is cherry red color. So it is important property or identification property for the hematite. So after color, streak, third property is luster. Luster is nothing but again the light reflecting property on which the mineral surface reflects. So for example, again I will take the hematite. It shows me the presence of metal into it because it is shining. So it is called as metallic luster. For example, if I take this quartz sample, maybe transparent or the rosy quartz, this will look like broken glassy material. So it is called as vitreous luster. Some of the minerals will show presence of wax into it, and it is called as waxy luster. So this is how different lustres are defined in case of minerals, that is again the light reflecting property. So after color, streak, luster, the next property is diaphanity. Diaphanity is also the light reflecting property. When the light passes thoroughly, totally from the mineral, for example is mica. Mica is totally transparent, so it is, its diaphanity is transparent. If I pass light through this, it will partially go. So I'm going to show you light reflecting properties. Again, I show you mica, that light passes through this totally, so it is called as transparent. Light passes partially through this, so it is called as translucent. And light cannot pass through this, so it is called as opaque. So this is how diaphanity of the mineral has been checked. So after color, streak, luster, diaphanity, next property is hardness. So hardness scale is the standard Mohs hardness scale we use for this practical. So Mohs hardness scale is, you can show here, that is hardness 1 is tar, gypsum, calcite, fluorite, apatite, feldspar, quartz, topaz, corundum and diamond. So this is the standard hardness scale. So how do we check the hardness scale in the field? That is, some of the minerals we can scratch easily by our fingernails. And see, we can have the powder on hand. So it is very easy to scratch. So this is hardness 1. And also I can scratch the another mineral by my fingernail, that is gypsum. So hardness 1 and 2 we can scratch it by our fingernail. So our fingernail has the hardness between 2 to 3. And later we have calcite has the hardness 3. Then fluorite has the hardness 4. And so on. So we can check the hardness of the minerals by scratching the minerals, two unknown minerals on each other. So once we are scratching, more noise, less powder, hardness is more. I repeat, more noise, less powder, hardness is more. Less noise, more powder, hardness is less. Less noise, more power, hardness is more. Also we can check, you can hear the voice, that here voice is more. So both the minerals have the more hardness. So this is how we check the hardness in field. Otherwise in laboratories also you can have the hardness box, where standard 10 hardness 1 to 10 standard minerals are given and we can scratch on each other and then we can specify the hardness for these minerals. Next property after color, streak, luster, diaphanity and hardness is form. What form these minerals are? For example, this transparent quartz has the crystalline form. It is a proper crystal. This has lamellar form, that means it shows the lamellar structure. The minerals which do not have any particular structure, like for example is magnetite or rosy quartz, these are called as massive. Form is massive for this. Okay, so next property after the form is cleavage and fracture. So what is the major difference between cleavage and fracture is, when we hammer any mineral, how does it break into? If it breaks along with the crystal form, because minerals has the specific chemical composition and atomic structure. So once if it breaks along with its crystal shape, then it is called as cleavage. For example is calcite. When the calcite is hammered, it is broken into a smaller piece. You can see here. And it has given me a perfect square, so that means it is broken along with its crystal shape. But when I break the other minerals, that is if I break the quartz, it will give you irregular scratches. Irregular breaks along with the mineral is called as fracture. So the minerals which do not show cleavage will show the fracture. So fractures are nothing but irregular breaks observed on the surface of the mineral. So that is all about cleavage and fracture. So color, streak, luster, diaphanity, form or habit, the same thing. Then hardness, cleavage and fracture, these are the major physical properties of these minerals. After studying all these properties, we can come to the conclusion that this particular mineral is a quartz or this particular mineral is a gypsum. And so we can write the name of the mineral, and then we should write the important things. Like for example, ore minerals are the iron. This is iron ore mineral, and these ore minerals, you should write the chemical composition as well as you should write the uses of this mineral as it is used for the iron production. So that is all about practical number one to identify the mineral specimen. We come to the conclusion and we should write the chemical composition and uses of mineral. The more minerals you see in the field, the more minerals you handle with your hand, then you will get to know what kind of mineral it is. Practice makes you perfect. So of course, you should be able to handle these minerals. Okay, thank you.